Hello there, my name is Anthony Varokas. I'm here for Streaming Media Producer here at NAB 2019. I'm in the New Tech booth with Will Waters. There is so much that was announced just before and at NAB. It's almost like I can't even wrap my mind around it. Vizart, NDI, the new Advanced Edition just popped out just before NAB. What does all this mean for streaming media producers who are using new tech hardware? Let's start with Vizart, the big thing first.
Well, Vizart announced a acquisition of new tech. And what this really means for everyone is that there's some really exciting stuff on the way. Vizart is a company that might not be familiar to many of new tech customers or TriCaster customers, or even those that work in streaming. They are a company that is very well known in the broadcast space with high-end graphics and incredible technology. But what's important here is that they are software driven. They really understand the philosophy or the idea behind doing productions and making tools that create stories through video, and that's driven by software.
I mean, I see a lot of synergy. When I looked at it, I says, well, you've got the virtual sets, and that's kind of like a Vizart thing. Yep. And I could just imagine the virtual sets all of a sudden becoming like, whoa, now look what I can do.
Well, it's a little too early to get into specifics of how all of this is going to be put together. But really, you know, New Tech and Vizart has been... we've been collaborating for a number of years now. I mean, we have a few different products together. We have some controls and on those customers that have that cross-pollination. But we just see that they're very strong in their brand and with their customer base. New Tech has a very strong brand with this customer base, and we don't see that as being messing with that at all. I mean, this is one of these things where a lot of times these acquisitions come in like, well, how can you pull different things out and kind of strip things out and all that?
Right.
This is really as best it can be, or best we can talk about, is just there's no real overlap except in the idea of philosophy for delivering tools for video producers. So we're really excited about what the future can hold there, and really the combined development that can come about with that.
And as a New Tech TriCaster owner, I looked at that and I just look forward to like what additional things can come my way. And speaking of that, we talked about the new version of NDI is like huge.
Yeah, it's a big announcement that we have. So it's version 4 of NDI, which, we announced that, 3.5 years ago, and it's been like trying to lasso a rocket ship. We're from Texas, you gotta put that in there.
Yeah.
But it's an amazing thing. So with some really interesting announcements that I think are interesting for both developers, but as well as end users. From the developing standpoint, there's some under the hood multi-TCP connections that we can take better advantage of, and of course 16-bit color space for that side. But for an end user standpoint, we bring about some features that are really cool, such as NDI recording.
Yeah.
And what this means is that basically once you have NDI flowing on your network, because it's really important to say IP is not just about replacing a wire.
Right.
IP in your video production means that you can expand your workflow, do things you never really thought about before.
Right.
So this allows you to take recording or take that NDI flow and write it directly to disk without additional CPU overhead.
Right.
Now, all that technical stuff really means is that you can basically, as long as you have hard drive space and a fast enough throughput there, you basically can take all of your various sources that are flowing across your network, write them to disk, and then utilize that in ways that you really required a lot of work and effort to be able to get to before.
Right. I know, like on my TriCaster, it's like, well, which one do I ISO? Now it's sort of like, oh, anything that's NDI, I can just keep it.
But keep in mind, this is the entire NDI ecosystem.
Yeah.
So NDI, 63 different companies here at NAB with an NDI product. Of course, thousands of downloads to the SDK. This is really mammoth. Now, there is something there that we have to bring in, because that is for free. But New Tech will also be releasing a plugin, because you need to line these things up. When you have multi-cam editing, like there's clock sources or different things. I mean, we can get into all the weeds of the technical bits, but you need to be able to keep that in sync. Well, with timecode now, NDI can lay timecode directly into the file, which this plugin that we will have available about the same time, there will be a cost there, but it'll be minimal. But it'll work with the Creative Cloud suite, such as Premiere, After Effects, and Media Encoder.
Right.
But you'll be able to basically line that up and utilize multicam editing in a way that previously has been a real big headache.
Right. So that'll be huge for people content producers that, you know, in addition to live, now there's this whole post aspect about it that NDI truly facilitates, which NDI wasn't really a post thing before. It was more of a, like, just get ingest type of thing.
That's correct. That's correct.
And then I think another another announcement, not necessarily an NAB announcement, but the Advanced Edition 3, which, you know, for everyone who has hardware, it's sort of like, I looked at that and I says, wow, there's some serious new capabilities there.
Absolutely. So Advanced Edition 3 is something that we announced for our those that have bought TriCasters, various models like the Mini or the 860, 8000 in previous years. And some of that hardware you can update to Advanced Edition 3, but this is what's really important for an NAB announcement. And that is, we're bringing premium access, which is our current feature set, to those products. So if you have Advanced Edition 3, you're now going to be able to take advantage of some of the latest feature set and tools that we're delivering. And this is, again, the advantage of that software-driven production.
Right, right. So, you know, I was looking at that, and there's a whole collection of, you know, interesting pieces and connectivity and templates and database-driven things.
There's a big, long list, but I can tell you the one that's got the most buzz here, or I guess people are just kind of keep coming back and saying, yeah, what's that again? Like, just, you can see the wheels turning from the producer standpoint. It's something we're calling Live Story Creator. Now, you use Microsoft Word. I know that I'm like switching gears here real quick, but you know, we kind of started thinking about video production in a different way, because where does it start? And a lot of times you say, well, the camera, and then we think about the bits and the wire and the software and all that, but really it starts with the story.
Right.
Or the script.
Yeah.
Right, so you sit down. So it's like, how can we utilize that? So now with Premium Access and Live Story Creator, you can take your script, put your headers in, and say Will, and it will cut to Will in that header. As it goes through it, giving you also teleprompting. And actually use
Does it bring in titles?
It can, because you can put a comment right within the Word document and say, put this title on, or here's my super. And there's some intelligence here, because it's just standard conversational English.
Right.
You don't have to learn a scripting language to be able to do this. And this is something really powerful for those studio producers who may not have a full automation pipeline to work with. But you can utilize a tool like Google Docs, Pages, OpenOffice, Microsoft Word, to deliver that DOCX file, put that right into TriCaster.
That is very, very cool. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to talk with me. My name is Anthony Barocas, here with Will at the New Tech booth here at NAB 2019 for Streaming Media Producer. Thanks for watching.